even famous French visionary and novelist Jules Verne, the guy who imagined electric-powered submarines in his wildly popular 1870 sci-fi title 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, could have foreseen a Bentley SUV. The same could be said of Bentley's equally famed founder, W.O. Bentley himself, who could never have dreamed that one day, nearly 100 years on, the company's very existence would largely depend on the success of its high-riding subs over the drawcard value of Bentley's hugely successful Le Mans conquering supercars of the early 20th century. Success, as it turned out, didn't take long either, with sales of Bentley's first ever SUV, the mega-powered 6.0-liter Bentayga W12 notching up a staggering 5,586 units all on its own. That's just 645 short of the entire Bentley production over 2016. Not bad for a five-seat SUV with polarizing looks and a stratospheric $427,300, plus on roads, price tag to boot. However, 2017 produced an even more one-sided result, with Bentayga sales rising to more than 10,000, thanks to the introduction of an additional powertrain, Bentley's first-ever diesel. It used a sophisticated V8 engine derived from Wattie's tech-heavy 4.0-liter twin-turbo diesel V8 from the SQ7, sending 320 kilowatts of power and 900 Nm of industrial-grade twist to all four wheels. That's precisely the same torque output as the range-topping W12 developed, but the diesel also boasted a range of up to 1,000 kilometers from an 85-liter fuel tank, making it a thoroughly worthwhile addition to the brand and its ever-growing clientele, not to mention the company's bank balance. But Porsche's recent announcement that it will cease all production of diesel engines in 2018 would appear to cast a wider shadow over the entire auto industry, and could quite literally spell the end of diesel-powered vehicles in general. And that's precisely where the Bentayga V8 comes into the picture. Although, what's interesting, at least for the moment, is that it will be priced just below the diesel variant at $334,700, meaning it will launch locally from June as the new entry-level Bentayga, even though it's the quicker of the two. It's worth remembering the first high-riding Bentley caused a global sensation when it was announced that despite tipping the scales at a tank rivaling 2,440 kilograms, it could still hustle from standstill to 100 kilometers per hour in a head-spinning 4.1 seconds. The $335,000 Bentayga diesel is heavier still, showing 2,449 kilograms on the sales. But it's no slouch either, managing to cover the benchmark sprint in a Cayenne crushing 4.8 seconds flat.